Hello everyone, in this video we're going to discuss how to find slant or oblique asymptotes. Okay, so if I give you a function like fx is equal to 4x squared divided by x plus 3. Notice that you can't use the techniques of finding horizontal asymptotes here. Well, if you try, you will see that the only term, in fact, in the numerator has a power greater than the leading term in the denominator. So as a result, there are no horizontal asymptotes, okay, whatsoever. However, there is a vertical asymptote because, you know, this can be set to zero and the x value will be found that will represent the equation of a vertical asymptote. And the top, and in the case where the power for the term in the numerator, the leading term, exceeds the power for the leading term in the denominator, basically, it means that it will be treated as an improper fraction. Okay? So as an improper fraction, you will make sure that you divide 4x squared over x plus 3, right? So improper means that you will not have, you can obtain a quotient and you can obtain a remainder which will be divided by the divisor. Alright, so let's use long division to divide 4x squared divided by x plus 3. Okay, so I'm going to show you why we're going to use long division to find oblique or slant asymptotes. So 4x squared divided by x gives you 4x, multiply it back, you get 4x squared, and then we can treat this as a 0 after that, and then multiplying 3 plus 4x gives us plus 12x, right? So you subtract these two guys, and you will have 0 and then minus 12x. And notice that the quotient is simply 4x minus 12x divided by x plus 3. And actually, you're not done yet, right? So, yeah, so we should keep going. Okay, we should keep going because we can still divide the negative 12x by x plus 3. So dividing that will give us minus 12. Okay, multiplying back, we get minus 12x. Then treat this as a 0 after that, as a constant 0. And then multiplying the negative 12 by 3 gives us negative 36. Subtracting gives us 0 plus 36, right? Because there are two negatives involved, so plus 36. So now you can express this as 4x minus 12, that's the quotient. And then the remainder will be added and divided by the divisor still, okay? So what is going to be the oblique asymptote? It's going to be this. That's going to be the equation of the slant. I'm going to say slash oblique because there's another name for slant as well. Asymptote. So the quotient will be the equation of the slant or oblique asymptote. So for example, if we try to graph it, I'm not going to go into detail about how to graph this, but 4x minus 12, right? So basically, as x approaches infinity or negative infinity, the function value will approach this equation of the slant or oblique asymptote. It will approach this, 4x minus 12, right? So how to graph 4x minus 12? So as you know, whatever, this will be the y-intercept for this equation, 4x minus 12. Okay, so, and you know the slope increases by 4 per unit, so it's going to be 4, 4, 4, and so on, right? So, and when y is equal to 0, 4x is equal to 12, so that's going to give us x is equal to 3, right? So, basically, I should indicate this as a dashed line. This will be the slant asymptote, right? So the function value, when you go from negative infinity to positive infinity, it will approach this slant asymptote on both sides, okay? But now let's figure out the vertical asymptote. Okay, so the vertical asymptote is found when you set the denominator equal to 0, so x is equal to negative 3, right? So x is equal to negative 3 is a vertical asymptote. That's the equation. Okay, so probably, and notice that as the function, as the x approaches this value of negative 3, the function usually on one side will go infinitely up, and on the other side it will go infinitely down. I'm not going to inspect it to see which one it's going to be. But basically, and notice that these asymptotes will meet at some point, the slant asymptotes. So you'll likely have an equation that goes something like this. Let me draw it better. It will look something like this. Okay. I don't guarantee it because I'm not going to inspect it, but usually that's what happens. Okay, and on the other side, of course, the function values will approach these asymptotes in the same way, but on the other side of each of the asymptotes that we found. Okay, but this is not a graph type of example. This is just a theoretical example of finding the vertical and horizontal oblique slant asymptotes. Okay, we're going to talk about graphing in our videos at some point. But I hope you understand how to find the equation of a slant oblique asymptote in this video. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video.